Hello everyone, I'm Amethyst Ring Witch and today I'm going to be doing some of my own Epsom salts. So I wanted you guys to come along and see how I have researched how to do it. There's a lot of different ways. Some recipes say you need Epsom salts, baking soda and sea salt. I don't have sea salt and I don't have a lot of baking soda, so I can't use those, but that's not to say that you guys can't use them. It's perfectly fine for you to go and use those recipes versus the one I'm showing. So for this I've got just some plain Epsom salts. There's no essential oils been added to them. I'm going to be doing that. I've got two blends that I rummaged through and looked at. The first is a relaxing blend, and this one has lavender and mandarin oils. And then the other one is a Witch Casket item. So this is one that I received in Witch Casket sometime last year, possibly the year before, and this one has patchouli, orange and cinnamon. Yes, I did look at the back. I've written them on, otherwise I have to keep opening the box and that's just a little awkward, she says. So first off, Epsom salts. I'm just going to talk a little bit about Epsom salts. So Epsom salts, they're a type of salts to me. I know they're not actually, they're magnesium sulfate, but Epsom salts are really good. Salt in general is good for cleansing, for grounding, but Epsom salts are good for detoxing. So if you're trying to remove something from your life, possibly even people, you could use Epsom salts. And something that I found a little intriguing that I hadn't known about was that Epsom salts can clear auras and strengthen them. So Epsom salts are actually pretty useful when it comes to the magical side of life. Now, which one am I going to do first? Is it the lavender or the mandarin? Because I've got two different jars that I can use. Both are clean, both are very definitely clean. One is a green bottle. Probably going to use this for the abundance blend. I'll do that one first. So the abundance blend is quite literally, as it states on the tin, it's all about abundance. So I'm going to, because I've got a larger bottle for this blend, I've just got a cup, a measuring cup. Oh, that'll about do it. Nice clean bowl. That is quite an amount of Epsom salts, and I think it was 2 to 4. The recipes that I've seen were pretty much 2 to 4 cups for four drops. But again, you can make it as aromatic as you want. There's no right way or wrong way with this. Definitely smell the cinnamon and the orange. So this could be a really good one to use at Yule as well, because of the orange and cinnamon ingredient associations. I've just put a few drops in. Now I'm just going to mix it all up. with just breaking up the chunks. So with this, the as I said, it's got the patchouli, orange and cinnamon in it. So patchouli is, obviously it's all about abundance, but patchouli is also associated with spiritual growth, courage, relaxation and protection. So again, if you have this kind of blend, and as much as, you know, it's come saying it's an abundance blend, you could also use it for other things. Because orange is also about divination and success. So it's a very vibrant, and it's uplifting as well. So if you're feeling a little bit down, you can always use, say, a tea that's got some form of citrus in it, or you know, just having the smell. A wax melt, an oil on a burner. I think this is as blended as I need it to be. So that's not really taken too long. And it's not overpowering for me, that's perfect. So I've added just the right amount. So I had 1 cup of salts, and I added about 8 or 9 drops of the oil blend. So I'm going to pop that oil blend away. But again, there's cinnamon in it, so there's a bit of a kick. Cinnamon's one of those, if you want to add a bit of extra power or energy to something, add some cinnamon. Ginger's another good one. So the cinnamony, gingery types are really good for you know, that type of just giving it a bit of an extra kick. So next I'm doing the relaxing blend, which is lavender and mandarin. So mandarin's another citrus. There's differing ideas and beliefs that mandarins are the original oranges, and anything orangey, tangerine, clementine, all of those come from the mandarin, because obviously we've done, as science has allowed us, we've, you know, worked with modern science in that respect. So that's an extra little bit. New bowl for the new blend. And I'm not going to use quite as much salt this time, and I'm not going to be putting in quite as much oil either, because I've only got a little one. So this will be for the relaxing blend. So I've got half a cup measurement. So half a cup of the salts. Just going to now which way do I open this one? That way. So with this one, it's Ancient Wisdom's relaxing blend. Fairly certain I've smelled it. And I'm also going to be adding in some dried lavender. So as well as the oil, it's going to have dried lavender in it. I'm going to add the oil in first and then the lavender, so that the lavender doesn't soak up the oil. So I've got half a So that one ended up with 4 drops. I didn't want too much, just purely because it can be quite overpowering. It is quite a strong lavender. It's known the world over for the relaxing, peaceful, the sleep, you know, that deep relaxation to get to sleep. It's in a lot of products that I use to help me get to sleep, as I do have some sleep issues. I love my sleep, can't always get to sleep when I want to though, so there is that. Any clumps left? So lavender, I have quite a personal relationship with myself, but again, it's, you know, it's, if lavender's not the plant for you, it's not the plant for you. So if you can find a relaxing blend that doesn't have lavender in it and you really like it and you want to substitute it for, you know, the salts, that's absolutely fine. So now I'm just going to grab, don't want to put too much in. Okay, just one little spoonful. So mandarin is, it's part of the citrus family, so it's another, you know, multi-use. I love multi-use things. I love it. So mandarin's good for sweetening because it's much sweeter than a modern orange. There's the tranquility and safe feelings of safety about it as well. There is a calming, soothing energy to it, which is probably why it's in the relaxing blend. But with the citrus, there's also an element of confidence and success. And, you know, there's, again, abundance. So this could be used for, say, an abundance of peace, an abundance of relaxation, you know, however you want to do it. So those are my two blends. I'm just going to stir those in. So that's my lavender, my relaxing Epsom salt blend with the lavender and mandarin relaxation blend from Ancient Wisdom. And then of course I have the abundance blend with the patchouli, cinnamon and orange. It looks like your normal salt, but there is a bit of a yellow tinge to it. My camera might not pick it up, but I can see that it's not pure white, there's an off-white element to it. So that I'm going to put in the green jar. The lavender I'll put in my little ball. And I hope you've enjoyed this. I hope it encourages you to see what else you could do. I've got a few more oil blends that I'm going to try and use this year. I'm working on my green witchery, home witchery and all of that. So I hope you've enjoyed this. If you have enjoyed it, please give it a thumbs up. If you think you know someone who would like to experiment with Epsom salts without baking soda and sea salt, feel free to share it. And I will see you again soon for some more magical fun. Stay safe, everyone. Blessings to you all.